So this was the year of the anthology films. Hello guys, it's Nona Prince and today we'll be talking about Paava Kadaigal, the new anthology series which came out on Netflix. It's done by four well-known Tamil directors, Sudha Kongra, Gautam Menon, Vetri Maran and Vignesh Sivan. We had a lot of anthology series this year, have not seen the new unpaused, the Hindi one. The first thing I want to mention is, what is the role of a short film? You know, each of these anthologies are short films, right? 30-32 minutes. And for me, there should be a purpose why this story is told in such a way, right? It is in a way very similar to making a feature film, but it's very short. So it should be clear why this story is being told in a shorter way. What's the meaning of it? And the last Tamil anthology, it really didn't work because any of the stories in that could be made into a feature film. It doesn't change. This is not a rule, but it's just what I think about short films. Because if you can make it in any medium, anything, then there's no meaning of making it a short film. Either you want to just make it and show it to someone and make it a feature film, but that's not the case here. So in that aspect, this anthology really worked for me because here they took one similar issue and theme and told a story around it. And after watching these stories, you understand why they are short films. It doesn't feel like, oh, it could have been more shorter or it could have been a feature film. Doesn't really matter. Now, most anthology films are all together. One by one, we see each of them. But here, Netflix has given an option to watch it in an episodes. Now, if you have seen the interviews, there was, you know, debate among the directors whose film should be first or second. So instead of that, Netflix just, I think, put all the episodes separately. You can watch anyone, but definitely there's a format which film is on first and which is on the last, and I think that's the way Netflix wanted it. Do let me know in the comments, do you like this feature or you want these films to be all together as a one film? I would say this way is better because, you know, it opens it for more people to watch because its episodes are 30 minutes. Just watch it and come back later, watch the second one later, so you know there's a free time. Otherwise you have to sit for 2 hours long, so I think it's more accessible now. But do leave your thoughts below. I think all the four films are built around honor killing. It is the main theme of the anthology. And what I like that each film added more to this issue. It's not just that the parents are after the kids because they ran away or they fell in love with someone from lower caste. It's not just that. There are more elements which are depicted around it. And the film explores a lot of unknown sides too. And all the four shows how people keep honor over everything else. Even life. What can be above life? Nothing. And it is just so disturbing that people feel that and they are willing to kill people for it just to keep their honor. And it's not just them or their family, it's the whole society, their whole community. Even if something has happened in someone else's house, their honor is on stake. That's one of the biggest problems in India, that for so long we have been people of community that we have forgot about individuality. That every person belonging to that community have to think the same way. They should not think beyond that. And I think that's hurting our society a lot. So the first one, Thangam by Sudha Kongra, starring Shantanu Bhagyaraj, Kalidas Jayaram and many more. Now I would say the main story is a very cliche thing we have seen millions of times. But here, to freshen this up, instead of just having a male-female in this love triangle, we have a transgender, and that's a very new and fresh idea. I like that. But what didn't really work for me is that the treatment was same. There's nothing different happened. We have seen a lot of times that the third guy in the triangle sacrifices, and here it is literally sacrificing their love and life. So in that regard, I really didn't enjoy it because it was cliche, but you change the character, but still you implement the same story. I felt like it was too overtly executed, very loud, like a commercial film, which is Sudha Kongra known for, and I can understand that. But personally for me, it really didn't work. Even the climax, you know, to drive the point, it was too overt and too melodramatic for me, because when you exaggerate the pain too much, it loses its impact. And I talked about this in my color photo review too, that will be coming out soon. So to get that, to subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notification whenever it comes out. And you know, when there's a short story, a satire works better because it makes a statement and it leaves the audience to think about. But in this one, it was more kind of a moral science lesson which just weighed down for me. Now on Discord, if you're not part of it, do join it, link in below, become a part of the community. There I interacted with a lot of people and a lot of people really liked this one. And I can understand because the treatment is very commercial and it hits with a lot of people, but personally for me it didn't work. The performances were good. And about Kalidas Jayaram, a lot of people are praising him for his performance and he did really, really good job according to me too. But I again felt, you know, the same thing, that it was too much sometimes. Again, you know, the commercial thing. Maybe that was the way director wanted it, but I just felt it was a little too much. But that's what it is. The second one, Love Panna Utranam by Vignesh Sivan, starring Kalki Kekla, Anjali, Padam Kumar and many more. Now this one was really, really different and bold, and I think this is the first time I saw dark comedy using this issue. It's very difficult because it's very sensitive, you know, but comedy is a way which helps people to talk about these issues openly, and it's high time we should. Now this film starts off very differently. It breaks the fourth wall, and there are twists, thrills and suspense throughout, which gives you a feeling like Andhadhun. Now if you read the synopsis for this one on Netflix, it doesn't feel like the film is talking about such a heinous issue of honor killing, and in a way it's making fun of it and calling it out. Now this one too did fall for me in the last half. I think that whole redemption thing at the end really didn't work for me, but that twist was again good, but it couldn't save the shot for me. There were a lot of funny dialogues, ESPN joke and calling a guy KGF because he has a hairstyle of Yash, but I have to say this film really stick out because how different and unique it was. In this film the father uses that animal ideology that the lion and lioness are always together, monkeys together with monkeys and all of that, and there's a great dialogue that, you know, we all are humans. Yora didn't wanted to marry a monkey, she wanted to marry a human itself, but just because of the caste you killed her. That was powerful. Again at the ending the whole dialogue and the rap song felt a little too much for my taste. I'm a kind of person who likes things in the subtext, not on the face, on the nose, but I can totally understand why they want to do this way, because they want to reach more people, they want to reach the wider audience for whom you have to be little too much and little overt and on the face to make them understand these things. And you know, if you have to choose to make society better or to make a better film, personally as an artist you would want to make a better film, but making the society better will always triumph. I think the whole cast did a good job here, and the dwarf actor, I cannot find his name, I'm really sorry, he was really good. Now the third one, Van Mughal by Gautam Vasudev Menon, starring himself, Simran and many more. Now this one too, again in the name of honor, captures another big issue, and it makes you sick because it's too real. What the film portrays is just too real. Just open a newspaper, you'll find one news like this. It should happen to no one, but people are doing it to a minor too, a kid. What kind of monsters are these people? And you know, not just this film, all the four films, it's hard to watch, you know. Like I would not watch this film at night, and I would not watch this film again at all, any of them, because honestly it just shows you the mirror of the society, right? The society we are living in. Maybe it hasn't affected us, but it affects many. Now coming to the film, it kind of follows a very similar style of a feature film. You know, the first I think 8 minutes is to set up the whole family dynamics, what the characters, what they are doing. Then something happens which raises the stakes, we reach the midpoint, and then there's this climax. And I think what this one does is, it's not focused on the culprit or the victim, that how society has trained women to think everything is about honor and honor is in themselves. That if someone touches them, someone does anything to them, the honor is gone, they have ruined the house. And this is fed up to women from the earliest of ages, and we even see that in the film, how the mother is preparing her daughter how to become a woman, what is honor, where the honor lies. And because of that honor, they don't want to go to police, they don't want to report this heinous crime, and that is one of the biggest reasons that this crime still exists and still happens, because some people believe that nothing will happen to them because in the name of honor they'll not file a case, they are free to go. Just the number of cases reported in real life are so low just because of that, and people just blindly follow this. No one is there to question, no one just want to stop and question things which are set up around them for ages. They just think if the elders have told them, that's the truth, that's it, you cannot question it. I feel like the film was trying to throw us off that the father is going to kill her, but I think it became obvious that it would be the mother. And you know, the helplessness the characters have, we have watching it, that a crime is committed on you and you cannot do anything, you're just helpless. What kind of a society we are living in? And with the ending, I was not sure, did she really kill her daughter or not? She was thinking about it, so I had to go to Discord and ask people about it. I was not sure. I feel it was not clear enough what really happened, because in a way to show that someone is thinking it was all a dream or just procrastination, like shoot it in a different way so I can, you know, call out, oh, this was something else. But the way it's shot, it's consistent throughout, so I feel everything really happened. But at the end they show this scene and I don't understand really what really happened. I feel till now this one was the most realistic one, very grounded. Coming to the acting, Simran was just amazing, she was carrying this film. And Gautam Menon, I'm not sure, you know, let me know in the comments what are your thoughts on his acting. I feel he is very one-dimensional and he doesn't have many expressions to show. Maybe it's his character, but I also saw him in Trance, so it's very, you know, in both the films I feel like, you know, he's very similar. Could they have casted an actor instead of him only doing it? who knows. Now coming to the fourth one, Or Iravu by Vethrimaran, starring Sai Pallavi, Prakash Raj and many more. I think among the four, Vethrimaran is one of the biggest director and everyone was waiting for his film. And if you watched any of the interviews, you would know that the project was supposed to be making love story and all of that, but Vethri didn't want that. He thought, let's do something constructive. Not that love stories are not constructive, but he wanted to do something very real, something he would be interested in, and he chose Honor Killing, from where, you know, the project changed and it is what it is today. And he chose to do a real story, or maybe based on a real story. And I don't know how many of you noticed, but there was a reference to this film in Gautam Menon's film. There was a poster where it says, the father killed the daughter. So we already knew, if you noticed, knew the outcome of the story. Now after watching this story, I don't feel like it was really a spoiler or something like that. It doesn't really change anything, because this film is very different. It's not about, oh, the father killed the daughter. It's about how he killed her. He wants to show the killing, you know, the whole struggle, the whole part. He wants the audience to sit and watch all of that, what really happens, how the person dies slowly, painfully. There's no cutaway at all. It's not like, oh, she's coughing, she's fallen, and cut, she's dead. No. Vethrimaran wants us to feel that pain, you know. He wants us to go through that suffering with the characters. The film also shows, you know, how the family suffered because she ran away from there. You know, how the society tortured these people because their child wanted something else and didn't confine to their norms. And the film shows, you know, one of the major issue of this honor killing. Why it happens? Because the society makes it difficult for these people to live. His other daughter's marriage proposal is cancelled because the daughter who eloped is pregnant with the child of a lower caste person. Like, how insane is this? How the brother suffered, how the other girl suffered, that they were stopped from going to school, no studies, nothing. Because they'll also follow her footstep and elope. Now, I've been talking about this for a long time that, you know, I want something different from Vethrimaran, the way he shoots his film and all of that, the color palette he uses. And this one is definitely very different. And I really like the camera work. It's very, very different, very symmetrical for change. And he's also in a very modern setting too in this film. If you look closely, there are a lot of metaphors in each scene. Coming to editing, I really didn't enjoy it. There were some instances where I didn't like how it was cut down. Some of the talking scenes, it was just, you know, weird, and it put me out of the film. Again, you know, Vethrimaran likes to keep everything real. I liked how they were intercutting what is happening now and what happened, which led to this. That was a really good idea. That was a fun idea which worked. And I like the fact that the film doesn't waste time to set up things which we already understand, you know. She ran away from home, now she's married, she's having a kid. There are dialogues throughout the film from which you can make up the backstory yourself and you don't need to set up everything. Coming to the performances, I think Sai Pallavi and Prakash Raj both did a really, really good job. That whole sequence where they both are suffering in a different way, it's very well shot and very well performed. You know, at the end, all the four stories, all the four films really come together and become a good anthology series, and I have to say one of the strongest one we have got till now. You know, it's good to see that finally we are getting, you know, content from South on Amazon and Netflix, and hopefully we'll get much better content where, you know, there's no box office stuff, anything like that. We'll get better stories, better performances in future, like we are getting it for Hindi. So there's a better future ahead. Fingers crossed. So guys, that was a review. I got late to this because I was busy with something and couldn't watch the film sooner. If you enjoyed this video, hit the like button, share this video, let me know in the comments your thoughts. More fun stuff coming. Check out the videos till then. And if you haven't subscribed yet, consider subscribing. And I'll see you later.